Hey, how you doing? It's Emilio here, and in this video, we're going to be talking about the importance of email encryption. You've got point A, point B, an email is being sent, and you want that email to be encrypted, to be scrambled. We're going to be talking about that in this video. Before we do get into that, please remember to click on that subscription button. This video is brought to you by Moonlock, where we do cybersecurity software for humans. And remember to click on that bell as well so you don't miss out on any of the videos that we are releasing. Email encryption. Let's talk a little bit first about encryption in general. Essentially, you're getting some data across computers, data across email systems, and you are scrambling that data. You're making that data unreadable, except for the people that need to be able to read it. So you're sending an email, you're sending it to somebody on the other end, and you wanna make sure that nobody in the middle there is actually getting your email and being able to read the contents of your email. So by encrypting your data, you're essentially locking the door and you're giving the key to the person on the other side who can then unlock the door and then read your email. So even if somebody in the middle gets access to your email, they grab your email and they try to read it, they will not be able to because it's scrambled and it's encrypted. Amazing. We're going to be showing you on my Mac how to get this set up across some of the core applications. Let's go and show you that right now. Onto my computer we go. Now that we're on our Mac, we're going to show you a few things that we can do. The first is to actually create a certificate, signing up with a CA, get a certificate, and then using that. The next is to actually use Gmail, where you can encrypt emails directly within the Gmail space. And then thirdly, how to actually send a file itself being encrypted as an attachment. Opening up our keychain access, you can go search for it in your spotlight. You're gonna go to keychain access. You're gonna look for certificate assistant. Now you can do a few things in here. The one that we're gonna be doing to do it properly is to request a certificate from a certificate authority. Couple of ways to do this, throw in your email address, throw in your name, and then you can either email the CA if you know the email address of the certificate authority, or you can save it to disk and send it to them separately. Follow those steps, continue. You'll then need to buy a certificate. They'll send it to you and then you go ahead and add it in. And once you do get your cert, you literally just double click on it and it should show up inside of your keychain access under the certificate section. Once that's done, you just open up your mail on your Mac, compose a new email, and now you can send some encrypted mail using that certificate. Likewise, when you receive an email, you will now see that that email is trusted and secure because of that same notification. All right, let's now do this using Gmail. We're gonna open up a web browser, whether that be Safari, Google Chrome, Firefox. The nice thing about this process is you don't have to do all the private key stuff. Right out of the box, Gmail lets you send a password encrypted file. Essentially, you're gonna have to have a code that you will send to the person on the other end. They just put in the code and then they can see your encrypted email. Here we are on our computer. I'm logged into my Gmail account. I'm logged in here using a Google Chrome browser. I'm gonna click on Compose. It's gonna open up a little Compose new message window. You can see on the bottom corner, you've got this little lock. It actually says toggle confidential mode. Confidential mode, I'm gonna click on this and it's gonna give me two main options. One being no SMS, the second being SMS. Before we go that, set expiration. How long do you want this confidential mode to be turned on? What you're hoping for is that within that 1 month, that person has gone in and opened up their email. Otherwise, they're gonna be locked out. Then we set the SMS passcode. If you don't do an SMS passcode, this is going to actually send them an email address with a code they'll have to input. Otherwise, SMS password, you're gonna put in the telephone number of the person on the other end. They will then receive a PIN number, a code to their phone, which then they can use to unlock that email and see the contents of it. So, no SMS passcode, we're gonna click on save. It now says that contact will expire on that date. I can put in my recipient and then we can go ahead and send that one off. So what the email will look like is something like this. Digital by Computing, which is the email address that I'm sending it from in my Gmail, has sent you a confidential mode email address. This is a test. I can now click on view the email. I'm gonna click on that one. It's gonna open up a brand new window and it's now letting me know who we sent it and that it was sent to a specific email address. It's now gonna send a one-time passcode to that same email address that you can then go and input and verify that email address. Here's the email that I've been received. here's the passcode. I'm going to copy that passcode. I'm going to input it into there. Of course, this is going to be the person on the other end. We can submit, and then it's going to open up that email address and I can see exactly what is going on. Other way is to do it, as I said, via a SMS code. The process is going to be very much the same. It's just going to be sending me a code instead. I now input the telephone number of the person on the other end. Of course, you need to know their telephone number. Otherwise, this process is not going to work. Put in their country code and the telephone number. The person on the other end should now have received an email that looks just like this, and then click on send passcode. And then simply enter in the code that has been sent to that mobile number. And you should then receive and see the contents of the email. It's that easy. Now, if you just want to encrypt a file, you can actually do this right on the Mac. Actually encrypt whatever file you want, put a password against it, attach it as an attachment to an email, send it through. So on our Mac, we're gonna go and open up our disk utility right over here. On the top left-hand corner, we're gonna go to file, we're gonna go to new image, blank image. Over here, we're gonna give it a name, and then we're gonna go down to the encryption section and select some encryption right over here. We can select this one right over here. It's gonna ask me for a password, which I just go ahead and put in. The person on the other end will need to know that password. We've now got a mounted disk right over there. We're gonna open it up, and we now copy our files into there. That is now password protected. What we're now gonna do is we're gonna eject it. Now, all you simply do is you start an email and you're gonna attach it. Here's the file. You should know the password. And another option for you is to use Encrypto by MacPaul. You can download it completely for free from the Mac App Store. You open it up and then you literally just drop files in there to actually encrypt the files. It's super, super easy.
So you should now know how to send an encrypted email. Please do let me know down below in the comments what you thought of this video. Like this video as well, and do remember to subscribe to this channel, clicking on the notification bell so you don't miss out on any of these future videos. Thanks again for tuning in. We'll see you next time.